The next presentation named Dynamic Equilibrium of Climbing Robots Based on Stability Polyhedron for Gravity-Inertial Acceleration. Yes, the presenter is Warley Ribeiro.
Okay. Can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you. You may proceed.
Is it okay?
Yes.
Okay, so thank you very much. My name is Warley Ribeiro, a first year PhD student at the Space Robotics Lab in Tohoku University in Japan. And today I'll present about the dynamic equilibrium of climbing robots. So climbing robots can be used to achieve safe exploration in extreme environments such as disaster sites, cliffs, or even potential caves in the moon that could be provide shelter for humans in future space exploration. However, such natural rock environments, they're very challenging because they have a terrain with an unknown shape, and it's very challenging to keep the robot stable and stable locomotion. So spine type grippers are a suitable solution for the locomotion of robots. And here we have two examples, one, the microspine gripper developed by NASA JPL, and also a prototype we developed in our group here. So one important aspect of the locomotion of climbing robots is evaluating the equilibrium to prevent falls. So as all of you might know, the very first equilibrium criterion for legged robots was based on the support polygon, which is the polygon made by the contact points between the robot and the surface. But if you think about the climbing robot problem, we can compute the support polygon, but it has a very complex shape because we need to compute it based on the static equilibrium equations and friction conditions. So these give us some limitations to use this method by only being static and these complex calculations for the support polygon. And we also have the zero moment point, which got very popular in the field of humanoid robotics because it considered the dynamics. But we still have the limitation that we need to compute the support polygon to use the ZNP approach. So here we consider a scenario of climbing in a lunar cave using spine-type grippers. So we have this following conditions that require a better equilibrium evaluation method. So the low gravity makes the dynamics effects more relevant, and the unknown environment limits our knowledge of the friction conditions, and also the large number of contact points increases the number of equations we need to solve. So given those limitations, the objective of the work I'm presenting today is to develop an equilibrium evaluation method that combines both static and dynamic requirements based on the performance of spine-type grippers of climbing robots. So here we introduced the gravito-inertial acceleration vector, and by accounting for the maximum holding force instead of the friction characteristics, we can compute the region that limits equilibrium states for the gravito-inertial acceleration vector. So here, to define this maximum holding force, you can have two options, either doing it online by measuring it using force sensors, or doing offline by doing perforce evaluation of the gripper and combining that with the physical model. So here I have the contents of my presentation, and now I'll move on to the theory of the proposed method of the stability polyhedron. So first, I start by defining the tumble stability. So we consider a robot with n contact points and assuming no slippage, which is reasonable for the climbing robot's problems. We can define a tumbling axis between any two contact points. And from the total force and moment acting on the robot, which includes the gravity, inertial effects, external disturbances, we can compute the tumbling moment, MAB, around the tumbling axis. So if there's another point that prevents the tumbling motion of in the direction of the tumbling moment, the robot is in equilibrium. However, if there's no point, such as the case in the moment MBC, the robot is tumbling. So for the climbing robot with gripper case, we can also include the effects of the holding forces here. So the moment due to those holding forces can be included in the tumbling moment, and this effect is always opposite to the regular tumbling moment, either pushing the surface or preventing the robot from detaching. So here I introduce the gravito-inertial acceleration vector, for short GIA, which includes the effects of static effects from the gravity and dynamic effects from the center of gravity, and as you can see here in this slide. So we can consider the limit for the equilibrium when the tumbling moment is equal to zero. So if we introduce the GIA vector into the tumbling moment equation, we can obtain this following equation here in terms of the limit of this GIA vector, the robot posture based on the contact positions, total mass and holding forces. But mathematically, this equation represents a plane in the space and divides this acceleration space into two regions, one for stable and another for unstable GIA vectors. If you consider all the possible tumbling axes, we have to compute the intersection of all these planes that we can obtain. So this gives us this polyhedron here that we can call the stability polyhedron for GIA. And to check if the robot is in equilibrium, we simply have to compute this polyhedron and check if the GIA vector is inside it. So comparing this method presented here with other common equilibrium methods I showed before, the method we propose has a fast check and an easy visual comprehension similar to the spot polygon idea, but it also considers the dynamic effects similar to the ZNP approach. And if you, by considering also the gripper performance here using the maximum holding forces, it can be easily applied to the climbing case as shown below, while the polyhedron shape remains simple and fast to compute. Now I'll move on to the dynamic simulation. So here I'll show the simulation conditions. We have some fractal surface to emulate the natural environment and the lunar gravity. And for the robot I show here, it's based on the prototype we developed in Tohoku University. It's a four-legged robot with 1.8 kilograms and 3 actuators per leg. And for the simulation, we consider that each gripper has a 3.2 newtons of holding force. And the size of the robot is as shown here in this slide. So for the first case, I consider a static one. So the GIA vector here in red coincides with the gravity vector. And we can see the stability polyhedron here in blue is composed by three planes because we have three possible tumbling axes. And in this case, the GIA vector is inside the polyhedron, so the robot is in equilibrium. And for the second case, I have here a dynamic case where the robot's base has an acceleration along the Y direction. So here we can see that the GIA vector is outside the polyhedron, so it is a tumbling case. For more details of these simulation conditions, I have this source code on the GitHub page, so please check it. So finally, for this third simulation, here we have a robot climb on an emulated cave wall in Moon. So here we can see the stability polyhedron can be easily used in real time to check the equilibrium of the robot. So in this dynamic simulation, we can see the GIA vector changes every time step, but it remains inside the polyhedron, so this shows a stable case. So now I'll show some static experiments we conducted to validate the stability polyhedron. So the experiment was conducted on this wooden plate with changeable inclination. And as grasping targets, we use conic shapes covered with sandpaper to emulate the rock's roughness. And for the robot, we use the prototype that I showed before. And here, just for the holding forces, in reality, they're very variant. They change a lot based on how well the robot is grasping. So we conducted some experiments before to check these holding forces. So we use here the minimum value we obtained and the average value. So here, talking about the experiment I conducted, we aim to see if the robot is in equilibrium or not for the given inclination. So I placed the robot a few times on a fixed inclination and checked if it was tumbling or not, repeating for different inclinations. And I compared that with the results from the theory of the stability polyhedron that I show here. So here I simulated the stability polyhedron and compared to the GIA vector to obtain the maximum inclination So considering the minimum holding force, I got an inclination of 54.4. And for the average, I got an inclination of 70.9. And here I have the results of the experiments showing the blue stars in this graph that we can see the comparison for the grasping success rate for each inclination angle. So here we have a match between the experiments and simulations. So if you compare first of the minimum holding force, shown here by the orange dotted line, we obtained 100% of grasping success for an inclination smaller than 55 degrees. And for the average holding force here in the green dot line, we observed an approximated grasping force of grasping rates of 50% for the angle of 70.9. And now for the conclusions, we presented here a method to check the equilibrium of climbing robots based on the static and dynamic effects of the limits of holding forces. So by computing the stability polyhedron for the GIA, which can be applied for any surface or any gravity field, and based on the low computational cost method. And we also provide simulation experiments to validate the usability of this method. So thank you very much. Now I'm happy to answer any of your questions.
Thank you. Does anyone have any question? Please. Let me ask you a question then. If we put a payload on the robot in real time, should a robot understand that the effect of the mass distribution changing in time in real time, or should we give some limits for this polygon geometry?
So
because it can turn from stable to unstable.
Yes. So basically here two things would change if you add a mass. So in this equation here we would change the mass of the robot, of course, and it would change the acceleration. So we'll change here also this vector. So we'll change the shape of the polyhedron here, because we changed the mass of the robot, the mass of the system, and it will also change this vector I'm showing here in red. So yes, this work here can consider that in real time, if you can measure that somehow.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much.